Hello students, welcome to Crack Redway online learning platform. Today we have special guest Mr. Amit Gupta with us. Amit Gupta has cracked the RBI Grade B 2019 exam. So it was his second attempt for the RBI Grade B. So today we will ask the strategy, how did he prepare for this exam, and before that we will share his profile and the inspirational story of his journey to this RBI Grade B. Actually, Mr. Amit Gupta हैं, वो वाराणसी के मिर्जापुर से belong करते हैं और बचपन में ये दिल्ली की streets में, मतलब कनॉट प्लेस के आसपास इन्होंने टी स्टॉल पे भी काम किया, कुछ रेस्टोरेंट्स में भी काम किया था. उसके बाद इनका रिहेबिलेशन किया गया था सलाम बालक ट्रस्ट ने. सलाम बालक ट्रस्ट के यहीं पे इनकी स्टडीज हुई थी, स्कूलिंग है. उसके बाद इन्होंने बीटेक किया है वेलटेक यूनिवर्सिटी चेन्नई से. उसके बाद एक प्राइवेट कंपनी में जॉब किया, उसके बाद जेएलएल में, और नेक्स्ट उन्होंने फिर एक स्टार्टअप में अभी करंटली ये वर्किंग है फोटोनिशिया में. और इनके इन्होंने वर्क जॉब के साथ साथ ही प्रिपरेशन की थी. 2018 में इनका फर्स्ट अटैम्प्ट दिया था तो प्रीलिम्स में बाहर हो गए थे. 2019 इनका सेकेंड अटैम्प्ट था. और ये नॉन फाइनेंशियल बैकग्राउंड है एंड नॉन यूपीएससी कैंडिडेट है, तो बाकी जर्नी ये बताएंगे. इससे पहले, आप मिर्जापुर वाराणसी से बिलोंग करते हैं, तो सबसे पहले क्वेश्चन जाएगा जो भी एस्पिरेंट्स देख रहे हैं, तो मिर्जापुर टू वेब सीरीज अभी चल रही है, तो क्या एक थोड़ा सा हट के क्वेश्चन है कि क्या मिर्जापुर जैसा दिखाया गया है वैसा ही है या
नहीं? नहीं, मिर्जापुर बिल्कुल वैसा नहीं है. बहुत पीसफुल और बहुत, मतलब, सुंदर जगह है. जो भी उसमें दिखाया है उससे मिलता जुलता बिल्कुल नहीं.
तो अभी हम शुरुआत करते हैं फेज़ वन प्रिपरेशन से, एंड फिर फेज़ टू और फिर इंटरव्यू का डिटेल में डिस्कस करेंगे. तो फेज़ वन में इन्होंने कैसे प्रिपरेशन किया था, कितने मंथ का चाहिए आपको प्रिपेयर करना चाहिए, जो फ्यूचर एस्पिरेंट्स हैं उनके लिए?
एज यू सेड, मेरा सेकेंड अटैम्प्ट था इन 2018. इट वॉज 2018 वॉज माई फर्स्ट अटैम्प्ट फॉर आरबीआई ग्रेड बी एग्जाम, बट आई डिड नॉट क्वालिफाई प्रीलिम फेज ड्यू टू द स्केलिंग प्रॉब्लम. आई हैड अटेम्प्टेड अराउंड 130 क्वेश्चन, बट ड्यू टू स्केलिंग माई 20 मार्क्स वर रिड्यूस्ड, एंड ड्यू टू विच आई वॉज अनेबल टू क्वालिफाई दैट एग्जाम. बट सो सिंस आई हैड अटेम्प्टेड दिस एग्जाम अर्लियर, I was well aware that how the exam, what the exam pattern was and what type of questions are asked. तो इस साल वो मेरे लिए बहुत हेल्पफुल था. एंड तो एज यू ऑल नो कि देर आर 4 सेक्शंस इन दिस एग्जामिनेशन, प्रीलिम एग्जामिनेशन, जनरल अवेयरनेस, इंग्लिश, क्वांट एंड रीजनिंग. एंड आई वुड कैटेगराइज फॉर मी जनरल अवेयरनेस इन इंग्लिश, आई एम वेरी कम्फर्टेबल विद दो सब्जेक्ट्स. एंड रीजनिंग एंड मैथ इट्स क्वाइट डिफिकल्ट फॉर मी, सो आई प्लान माई प्रिपरेशन स्ट्रेटजी अकॉर्डिंगली. फॉर जनरल अवेयरनेस यू आस्क दैट हाउ मेनी मंथ्स करंट अफेयर आई कवर. सो एक्चुअली before I create this examination, I was used to covering general monthly current affairs every month. So it was, for me it was a continuous process. But with respect to examination, I concentrated on last 6 months general awareness. I know a few candidates who have cleared this examination by covering just 3 months current affairs.
Yeah, for phase one, I think three months.
3 months are sufficient.
Yeah. For phase two, you can go to 6 months.
Yeah, 6 months. And for general awareness, I covered from Bankers Adda, the Hindu capsules. It was my main source. And other than that, I covered MCQs, only MCQs part from Affairs Cloud and GK Today. Only MCQs, MCQs with solutions. Okay. I just read, had a simple reading. And
I will interrupt you here. So most of the aspirants have questions. They have asked many times that Affairs Cloud is so bulky.
Yes.
So you can get answer from here that he has prepared from the Bankers Adda 34 or 35 pages PDF that he knew that was enough, and MCQs means quiz or MCQs you have attempted from
GK Today and
Affairs Cloud. So it is for them, those who are asking that they how they should read the bulky PDFs of the Affairs Cloud.
It's not important.
I mean, banker said you can read.
Yeah. For bankers,
how much scored in GA?
I attempted 71 questions in GA and my score was 70.
Okay. So he has scored very well without reading Affairs Cloud PDF.
Yes.
That most of the students face the challenge in that reading.
It's not practically possible that you cover from page to page, I mean, like 400 pages in from Affairs Cloud. It's very difficult. It will take more than 1 week to cover the entire.
That was the source for the
general
awareness.
So, and for English, I didn't know. English के लिए मैंने कुछ खास किया नहीं. English is like सबको आता है. अगर सबने if anybody has cleared 12th class, then that is sufficient.
Yeah. And mock test से थोड़ा help मिल जाता होगा कि इंग्लिश में भी
यस एग्जैक्टली
क्वेश्चंस का पैटर्न पता चल जाए एक बार अटेम्प्ट कर सकता है. जनरल लेवल का रहता है इतना भी डिफिकल्ट नहीं है. बहुत सारे लोग भी ये क्वेश्चन करते हैं इंग्लिश बहुत डिफिकल्ट.
इजीली जो स्टूडेंट्स जो मैं जानता हूं जिनको जिनका क्लियर हुआ इजीली वो इंग्लिश पे इतना ध्यान नहीं देते. एवरीबॉडी इज कॉन्फिडेंट इन इंग्लिश. सबका इंग्लिश अच्छा जाएगा. सभी कॉन्फिडेंट है.
रीजनिंग पार्ट के लिए क्या क्या था? रीजनिंग में भी
रीजनिंग जो था मतलब मेरे लिए सबसे डिफिकल्ट पार्ट था रीजनिंग. बिकॉज मेरे को मैं मतलब आई कैन नॉट सॉल्व इन अ सिंपल सिटिंग अरेंजमेंट प्रॉब्लम एंड पजल मेरे से होता ही नहीं.
या 20 मार्क्स के लगभग पजल सिटिंग अरेंजमेंट ये आता है
20 नहीं लगभग 24 25 से लेके 30 के आसपास.
वही मतलब 20 से 30 का मतलब वो चेंज होता रहता है पैटर्न.
हाँ
कभी 20 मार्क्स का कभी
25
बट मोस्टली अदर क्वेश्चंस आर आल्सो देयर सो यू कैन अटेम्प्ट.
या आई ट्राइड अटेम्प्टिंग ऑल दोस इन नॉन पजल एंड नॉन सिटिंग अरेंजमेंट क्वेश्चंस. Almost I attempted 24 question out of 60 and I got around 18 marks. So I think that was okay. That was good attempt with high accuracy.
Yeah. So many students this question that they used to ask that what topics they should cover in the reasoning part and
see,
they are not able to.
Those who are preparing banking examination, most of them might be very comfortable with puzzle and sitting arrangement.
Yeah.
And those who don't have any experience solving these kind of problems, then they can make themselves comfortable other problems
like
syllogs,
inequality, input output, coding, decoding, correction, blur relation.
Yeah.
These are the topics
exactly.
Which are always asked.
Yeah, and
critical
few questions related
reasoning.
To critical reasoning.
Yeah.
Almost 10 questions are
there.
Asked. Yeah, are definitely there from this critical reasoning.
Yeah. So they can focus on these topics.
Yeah, exactly. If you are not comfortable, please try scoring well in general awareness in English.
Yeah. So any course you used for this preparation of the reasoning part?
No. I used freely available material on YouTube.
Yeah. Any reference channel or YouTube channel
would like
to suggest to the aspirants?
I would like to mention one, just one guy, Banker's Point guy, Anshul Saini, I think.
Okay.
His teachings are really, really nice.
Yeah.
And I used jo shortcut tricks hai, I utilize that. In examination, it worked in examination also.
Yeah, the Diksha also refers to the same thing, that Banker's Point. Yeah.
Yeah. And there's one another channel, Wi-Fi Study, they're also equally good.
Yeah.
I mainly went with Banker's Point.
So now it comes to the quant section.
Quants
also,
yeah,
many aspirants are afraid of that. The questions are being asked very difficult and how they will be able to, because of they Google it and find that previous year cutoffs are very low.
Yeah.
But that is not the correct thing, that questions are being asked very difficult.
Yeah,
so you can elaborate and you can tell them.
Actually, particularly with respect to the cutoff part, the cutoff is around 25% for
general category.
Yeah, for general category and 20% and then for other category. So that's why cutoff is really low, but it's not the real picture. In quant, the topics can be divided into two parts, like arithmetic and non-arithmetic. Non-arithmetic includes number series, approximation, quadratic equations. These are very easy topics and it can be covered, you know, it can be prepared by anybody. So reasoning, I'm also not comfortable with quant section as well.
Mm-hmm.
So I fully left that arithmetic part, like percentage, profit and loss, speed. I left those topics, I did not prepare at all. I focus mainly on approximation, number series, and quadratic equations, and then data interpretation.
Yeah.
So in quant section, I attempted around 16 questions, and I got around 17 marks due to scaling, I think.
So those who used to ask these questions that quant level is very difficult, so advice for them that they should focus on
number series, quadratic equations,
approximation.
These will equal to, I think, 10 marks.
And
if you are able to attempt on data interpretation question,
yeah,
15 marks.
1DI is, based on our experience, we are telling that 1DI is always of easy level.
Yes, exactly.
And even can easily do that.
Yes.
Yeah, so don't be afraid of the DI also, that one question is always easy, that will be covering 5 questions, so 5 marks.
5 marks, definitely one can gain 5 marks.
Any test series for phase 1, you would like to master?
Yeah, I subscribed Practice Mock as well as Olive Board, but I did not give even a single test. What I did was attempted general awareness questions. Like there are 80 questions in one test, so for 10 tests, there will be 800 questions which I covered from these test series. 800 plus 800 is equal to 1600 MCQs. It was really helpful for me general awareness preparation. So 1600 questions before examination, it was awesome. So that's why I scored around 70 marks in general.
So other things you did not?
No,
I did not. Then how did you manage in the final exam, phase 1?
As I said, in 2018, I had attempted phase 1 for RBI grade B exam, as well as I had attempted CB exam, so I was well aware what type of questions are asked and what are the patterns being followed. So I went accordingly.
Okay.
I did not do anything extra.
Yeah, so many aspirants also ask this question that how should they remember the current affair part. So revision is the key, and the multiple times you attempt the quizzes or MCQs.
Like to, interrupt you. Please limit your resources and read those again and again.
Yeah.
That's the mantra for the general awareness current affair.
That's for the phase 1.
Yeah.
Okay, thank you. So now comes to the phase 2 part. How did you prepare for the phase 2 that we will ask from you? And most of the students have the questions also about every section of the phase 2 part, like ESI, FM and English. So there are a number of questions, like for ESI, from where you should you prepare the government schemes. So one by one we will cover.
Yeah,
so
sure.
First of all, we will start from the ESI part, and ESI the static part.
Yeah.
So how much time they should focus on the static part? Actually, non-financial background students have mainly the question in their mind that they will not be able to compete if they are not doing the static part. But you can tell them how much marks are covered in the final paper from the static part, and from where you did the static part, or from where they can prepare the static part also.
As per the previous year questions paper, out of 100 marks, 60 marks are of current affairs nature, and 40 marks are of static type, which can out of which 20 can still be related to current affair. So out of 100, 80 questions are of current affairs nature, and 20 marks are of static. And for static part, there was one PDF available, on Telegram channels of Murnal's handouts, economy handouts, which he teaches for, I think, UPSC. But it has very much relevance to our preparation also. I mean, RBI grade B examination also. So I covered his PDF, 400 pages PDF, and it helped me clear all my basics. regarding economy and finance background. As you said, I'm from non-finance and economic background. So due to that PDF, I could easily get over all the jitter regarding finance and economy, basic terms and concepts.
Did you study Ramesh Singh, most of the...
No, I have that book. I have that book as well as PC Chandra book, but I did not even open or refer anything from that book.
Yeah.
If a student cannot, cannot go through Munal PDF, because that PDF is very, compact, Munal's PDF, and explanation, well explanations are not there for each and every topic. So if our students are not comfortable with that PDF, then they can choose Vivek Singh Economy. That book is really awesome. I have been through that, and that explains every concept very well.
Yeah, specifically for the non-financial who have zero and start, they are going to start from the zero.
Yeah. For basic. Please read that book.
That book is also helpful for the RBI parents. Yes. And what did the students do? I have seen many students, they simply we'll see the video and some reference of books written by the number of
I think
blogs that Ramesh Singh you should refer. They blindly will purchase.
Yeah,
the
they will everyone.
And Ramesh Singh you cannot read without having some base.
Basic.
At least you should have some base before reading that Ramesh Singh. That will helpful. I think Mrunal and
Vivek Singh
economy.
Yeah, either Vivek Singh or Mrunal.
Also, we have that we would like to tell the student that we have covered our static part from that guy Vivek Singh. Vivek. Only that has prepared the content.
Yeah, for ESI, after clearing my basics from these two sources, actually I mainly went with Mrunal. Somewhere I referred Vivek Singh. So after clearing basics, I went with for ESI. I went with Crack Grade B's compilation for current affair as well as the static part, and that compilation is very much relevant to the examination, and that was kind of nice compilation.
Yeah. And the four government schemes.
Again Crack Grade B compilation.
Many students used to ask they need to cover the PIB. Did you cover separately the PIB?
No. See, I would like to repeat again that I did not read any newspaper either for prelim as well as mains. I did not cover any the Hindu or Business Standard, Business Line, whatever other financial newspapers are there. PIB, I did not cover it. And like you said, other resources which the other coaching institutions or blogs mention. I did not cover anything.
Yeah, actually that's, you have to stick to the one source if you are preparing.
Yes.
Seriously.
As I said earlier, stick to limited resources and read those again and again.
Yeah.
That's the key for success.
If you are even subscribing any course, then stick to that.
Stick to
Have that course, and it will complicate only the preparation.
Yes, it will complicate the matter.
Yeah.
And at the end you will realize that you have no time. And you don't know, you are very, very much confused.
And that one more thing that student used to ask, that old government schemes are being asked in the RBI course. So what the students do, they used to start studying everything.
Yeah, whatever they get.
Every old schemes. So what is your suggestion to those aspirants? Did you cover all the old schemes?
There are some schemes which are very old, maybe 20 or 25 years old schemes, maximum 5 questions from those schemes will be there. You can leave that easily. Just forget it. Try to cover 95 marks well.
Yeah.
Even if you get 70, 75 out of those 95.
Also that previous year paper analysis says that the schemes which are being asked from the old schemes or the 20, 25 years, they are basically linked to the
current affairs. Yeah, current affairs happenings.
Yeah, they are linked to the current schemes. Suppose that currently that Ayushman Bharat is there. Mm-hmm. Rashtriya Swasthya Bima Yojana was the old scheme.
The old scheme, yeah.
So that can be asked. So like this only, those schemes they have to
cover. As I said, Crack Grade B's scheme compilation is really awesome. It covers everything. I would say like 2-3 questions this year itself, which was not covered anywhere, it was covered in that comparison.
Yeah, that our this year government schemes are also in huge demand. Every student is asking specifically for the government schemes.
Yeah, it's very, and really nice part, and I appreciate it.
Yeah. And report indices then?
Yeah, again from current affair, for phase 2 current affairs, and whatever relevant topics like indices, schemes, recent schemes and all other government announcement, RBI's announcement. I covered from grade B's current affair of last 6 months.
Okay, so your suggestion to the aspirants for the ESI?
Yes, sir. Please focus well on current affair parts. Don't be much worried about, you know, one or two questions which you don't find anywhere, because question papers are set in such a way that at least 10 to 15% questions will be of very difficult type, and it will be hard to find the resources for these questions. So like this year, ESI, I think if anyone is getting more than 60, it will be considered a good attempt.
Good score. Also, the one suggestion from our side that we would not like to say that students to subscribe any content or promoting any content.
Mm-hmm.
If anyone has time, he can prepare
themselves. It's not required that you
any course you can subscribe. You know, saying that you should subscribe our content. Any course you can subscribe.
Yeah.
But stick to that and analyze the paper and prepare accordingly. Don't go here and there.
Yeah. I know many students who have cracked this examination without subscribing any material.
Yeah.
They have studied their own and they have got rank place in this list.
Yeah, easily everything is available in the Google
and internet.
Yeah. So you have to do analysis only. That is a hard work. You have to do analysis the paper and then you can prepare. So that was for the ESI part. And ESI part, did you study the budget, economic survey? Sometimes questions are being asked.
One or two questions which were there in question paper. It was from ESI and budget part. And yes, I did prepare.
So economic survey, you also?
Economic survey as well as budget.
So that is also important for the ESI
very
part.
Important.
Actually, if it is old, then...
Yeah, actually, most of the questions, current affair questions, which are asked in the ESI section are related to one way or the other, related to economic survey and budgets.
Yeah.
Because if it is mentioned there, even a single word, it may be asked.
So the budget and economic survey are also important.
Yes.
And now finance and management part. So finance and management, static part from where did you prepare? For specifically first we will discuss for the finance.
For finance, I prepared myself note. I mean based on the syllabus, given syllabus. And each word of the syllabus, given syllabus is very important. So I tried to make notes and refer Googles, and then as I said, Vivek Singh and Munal, they have also covered these few of the topics I mentioned there.
Yeah.
So it was helpful. And then again, current affair is very important related to finance.
Yeah, specifically that RBI circulars.
RBI circulars.
Nowadays
yeah,
questions are being asked from number of questions.
Yeah.
Even in phase 1, number of questions.
Yes, yes.
They can ask from the RBI circulars and NABARD. Recently, number of questions were covered from the RBI circular. So, sometimes students ask that RBI circular they should read or not. They can get it compilation in various current affairs PDFs.
It's not that easy to know each and every
every circular
RBI circular.
So they can get it from the compilation of the PDFs.
And I would like to say that these compilations are freely available on internet.
Yeah.
You don't need to subscribe. You know.
Yeah. If anyone has time, easily you can prepare for that also. So finance. One more thing that PC Chandra, you was already heard that you
PC
did not study.
Yes, I had
the students. Many blog we have written.
Mention this.
They must study the PC Chandra.
Yeah.
So what is your take on this?
Bharti Pathak and PC Chandra. Then there's one other book of Mr. Khan, I think, the writer's name.
Yeah.
I did not, I mean, I bought one PC Chandra book, but I did not open that book even. I am still, it's still lying on my bookshelf. So, actually, I tried, what I did was, when I look at those, look at the topics, you know, and referred with that book, it's not that much relevant. That book is, has no relevance with respect to RBI credit examination. I'm talking about PC Chandra.
Yeah. So actually, that nowadays combination of so the static part as well as the current mainly RBI circular and economy and banking related news.
Yes.
Banking and finance
related news.
Like I remember that in 2018, priority sector lending, insolvency and bankruptcy code. In 2019, similarly, that appointment of directors related when RBI circular was there. So number of questions were asked. So current affairs related to this finance and banking is also very important for the finance paper. So one major thing students have always students are always confused about is numerical part. So they start studying in depth numericals in depth. And so what is your take and how did you prepare for the numericals? Did you prepare any?
Actually, I covered that 72 rule. Like in how many years the money is doubled, you know, 72 and 144, 112. I think there are three rules. That is very easy. Anybody can do that. And other than that, I did not cover anything. I mean, I tried tried to cover, you know, financial ratios, but I was not confident in that. So what I did was, if I thought that if such questions come in the examination, I will leave it. Like 4 or 5 marks, 6 marks, it's okay. I will do well in 94
marks. Some students, some previous blog says that 10 to 15 marks questions are being asked.
No, it's not like that.
But it's not
this
like
year,
that.
Not even a single question was asked.
Since last 2 years, there is very less. One or I think 2018 also 1 or 2 marks numerical part was asked in the phase 2 exam on FM paper.
Yeah.
And previously also not that 10 to 15 marks, but some questions were of general understanding. There no need to read any concept.
Exactly.
And basically if you are going to study the numerical part, so time value of money and some ratios, not all ratios, some ratio you can cover, and this rule 72 and this banking related ratio only you can cover, and the time value of money, that is enough. And time value of money easily can do. So don't go in depth. You will otherwise you will not be able to concentrate on other topics.
But from finance section, topics like, you know, time value of money, bonds, and risk management. Financial risk management.
Topics.
These are very important topics. Yes.
So that there's
Basel Accords. There are
Basel norms.
Very
always
very
questions are being asked.
Very important topic.
That is was for the finance part, and now the management part. Management is completely a theory part.
Theory part, Actually, again, I used internet extensively, and there was some few materials available on Telegram channel. I refer that, and again for MCQs, I referred your credit grading MCQs. That was really helpful for management as well as finance. It was really helpful.
So. Also, any website refer, mostly students refer that managementstudyguide.com.
No, no, I did not refer. I had no patience for that.
Yeah, student, if you can you want to refer, then you can also refer that managementstudyguide.com.
Yeah, I have been through that website, but I did not refer.
Okay. So that was the basically that questions or topics more. The student must focus on the topics more than others.
Yes, for finance
management.
Yeah. HRD, leadership, motivation, these are very important topics. One should definitely cover each and every.
There are various theories in motivation and leadership.
Always questioned again and again, you know. From like HRD, performance appraisal, there are few topics which are always asked. Same question again and again.
MBO, measurement by objectives.
Yeah.
Many times it has been repeated in the exam.
This year also it was.
Yeah.
This question was there.
So that's for the management part. Yeah. Any test series or mock you joined or?
For mock, I I took your grade B's phase 2 mock series, and then again I subscribed practice mock. But your, I mean, crack grade B's mock was very helpful, one of the best I can say, because most of the questions I can relate in phase 2 to your material. And from practice mock, what I did was just read those, you know, their questions. I did not attempt test. I read their questions and just try to mug up all the data that were there. Yeah. Data and few keywords and...
So that's for the finance and management part. अब हम बात करते हैं इंग्लिश की. सो इंग्लिश के लिए भी बहुत सारे स्टूडेंट पूछते हैं कि उन्हें कितने ऐसे राइट करके प्रैक्टिस करनी चाहिए, न्यूज़पेपर पढ़ने चाहिए, आर्टिकल्स पढ़ने चाहिए, कौन से इंग्लिश न्यूज़पेपर पढ़ने चाहिए, तो और ऐसे है वो कैसे लिखना चाहिए, बहुत फैंसी वर्ड्स के साथ, टेक्निकल वर्ड्स के साथ, बहुत हाईफाई मीन्स इंग्लिश लैंग्वेज के साथ लिखना चाहिए, तो ये भी बहुत सारे क्वेश्चन पूछे जाते हैं स्टूडेंट्स के द्वारा. तो आपने कैसे प्रिपेयर किया था इंग्लिश के लिए, कोई मॉक टेस्ट प्रैक्टिस किया था, कोई न्यूज़पेपर स्पेसिफिकली पढ़ा था या नहीं पढ़ा था, तो इसके बारे में आप बताइएगा.
जैसा आपने आपको मैंने बताया कि मैंने कोई न्यूज़पेपर नहीं पढ़ा ड्यूरिंग द प्रिपरेशन, बस मैं कंपाइलेशन पढ़ता था. तो लाइक इंग्लिश में कुछ टॉपिक्स आते हैं जो बहुत जनरल टॉपिक होता है और सबको पता होता है, हर कोई अटेम्प्ट कर सकता है. तो फॉर मी लाइक लास्ट ईयर 2019 में जनरल इलेक्शन जस्ट रिसेंटली कंक्लूडेड, तो मतलब बहुत डिस्कशन में भी था, तो हम आई वॉज इक्विप विथ कीवर्ड्स रिलेटेड टू. तो एक टॉपिक था इसमें हमारे क्वेश्चन में, क्वेश्चन पेपर में इंग्लिश के, इम्पोर्टेंस ऑफ वोटिंग इन अ डेमोक्रेसी. तो मैं बहुत आराम से कर दिया, और जो भी हमारा मतलब प्री नॉलेज था, डाटा फिगर सब, इट वॉज अराउंड द कॉर्नर, मतलब डिस्कशन हो ही रहा था उसके बारे में, तो वो सब यूटिलाइज करके मैंने 300 वर्ड्स में लिख दिया. तो व्हाट आई डिड वाज डिफरेंटली इज दैट आई डिड नॉट यूज फैंसी वर्ड्स, आई यूज वेरी सिंपल लैंग्वेज अंडरस्टैंडेबल बाय एनी यू इंग्लिश रीडर, एंड ट्राई टू मिनिमाइज ग्रामेटिकल एरर्स एज वेल एज आई स्टिक टू द वर्ड लिमिट.
एनी प्रैक्टिस?
नो, आई डिड नॉट डू एनी प्रैक्टिस, no typing practice on laptop and get that SM verified by any other mock tester.
Actually बहुत सारे स्टूडेंट के दिमाग में ये भी चल रहा है, कन्फ्यूजन में रहते हैं कि हमें प्रैक्टिस टाइपिंग स्पीड रिक्वायर्ड है इस एग्जाम के इंग्लिश के लिए.
90 मिनट मिलता है, आई थिंक दैट इज सफिशिएंट फॉर कोई कर सकता.
मतलब किसी को स्पेसिफिकली कोई टाइपिंग प्रैक्टिस की जरूरत नहीं है,
टाइपिंग स्पीड की. मोस्ट ऑफ द जो ग्रेजुएशन है, ग्रेजुएट है, जिन्होंने ग्रेजुएशन किया हुआ है, तो उनको थोड़ा बहुत तो बेसिक कंप्यूटर का नॉलेज होगा कि कौन से कीज कहाँ पर, वही नॉलेज चाहिए. दैट्स
हाँ, और आराम से किया जा सकता
है. मैंने एक घंटे में ख़त्म कर लिया था, हाफ एन आवर मैंने बस मतलब वही ग्रामेटिकल एरर और सब खत्म करने की कोशिश किया. बट मैं मतलब अपने वर्ड लिमिट को लेके बहुत स्ट्रिक्ट था कि मैं मुझे वर्ड लिमिट 2-4 वर्ड से ज़्यादा इधर उधर नहीं करना, तो वैसे ही मैंने फॉलो किया. एंड ग्रामेटिकल एरर जो था, स्पेलिंग एरर था, उसको मिनिमाइज करने की कोशिश की.
और एक मेजर मिस्टेक्स जो स्टूडेंट्स करते हैं जनरली क्या होता है, वो क्वेश्चन नंबर लिखना भूल जाते हैं. एक स्पेसिफिकली मेंशन किया जाता है कि आप क्वेश्चन नंबर मेंशन करो, प्रीसिज में टाइटल मेंशन, हेडिंग मतलब
हेडिंग मेंशन करना.
तो ये भी ध्यान रख सकते हैं जो एस्पायरेंट्स हैं, फ्यूचर एस्पायरेंट्स,
या क्वेश्चन नंबर, उसका सब हेडिंग एंड देन हेडलाइंस, जो भी टॉपिक का प्रीसिज का हेडलाइन जो है वो डेफिनेटली देना चाहिए. और एक पर्टिकुलरली मैं रीजनल लैंग्वेज वालों के लिए बोलना चाहूँगा, जो हिंदी मीडियम या रीजनल लैंग्वेज से जिन्होंने पढ़ाई करी है, ऑलमोस्ट एवरीवन यू नो बहुत वरीड रहते हैं इंग्लिश को लेके. प्लीज़ मतलब उतना वरीड रहने की जरूरत नहीं है, अगर किसी ने 12th क्लास इंग्लिश सब्जेक्ट पास किया है उसके वो कर सकते
हैं. सिंपल लैंग्वेज में,
सिंपल लैंग्वेज में, वेरी सिंपल, जो 12th या 10th क्लास लेवल का इंग्लिश ही चाहिए, कोई इसमें लिटरेचर मतलब एम ए का इंग्लिश लिटरेचर का एक्सपर्ट नहीं चाहिए इस इंग्लिश के लिए, मतलब ऐसे टाइप करनी चाहिए ऐसे अदर टॉपिक्स.
और जनरली क्या होता है कि ऐसे टॉपिक्स भी होते हैं वो जनरली करंट से लिंक की भी रहते हैं. हाँ, ऐसे होते हैं जनरली.
मैंने बोला जैसे
मोस्टली क्या है कि इस जो मतलब प्रीवियस ईयर एनालिसिस कहते हैं, जैसे क्वेश्चन हुआ टेक्नोलॉजी या साइबर सिक्योरिटी से रिलेटेड है, वुमेन एम्पावरमेंट से है, यूथ से रिलेटेड लाइक अनएम्प्लॉयमेंट है, लाइक लास्ट ईयर स्ट्रेस इन यूथ पूछा गया था, इम्पैक्ट ऑन इकोनॉमी, जो डिफरेंट डिफरेंट सिचुएशन आती रहती है इकोनॉमी में, लाइक एक बार डीमोनेटाइजेशन का इम्पैक्ट पूछा गया था, जीएसटी का पूछा गया था, एंड इस बार हो सकता है कि
कोविड से रिलेटेड डेफिनेटली आ सकता है,
आर्टिफिशियल इंटेलिजेंस न्यूज़ में है काफी, ब्लॉकचेन है, डिजिटल करेंसी है, ये टॉपिक है वो पूछे जा सकते हैं, मतलब सिलेक्टेड टॉपिक पढ़ के भी आप प्रिपेयर कर सकते हैं।
तो मैंने स्पेसिफिकली इंग्लिश के लिए कुछ प्रिपरेशन नहीं किया, कुछ नहीं पढ़ा, ना तो न्यूज़पेपर भी नहीं पढ़ा, कुछ प्रैक्टिस भी नहीं किया, एक भी दिन मैंने कुछ नहीं पढ़ा, मतलब जो मेरे पास प्री नॉलेज था उसी को मैंने यूज करके,
मतलब करंट अफेयर पढ़ रहे होते हैं तो उससे आपका नॉलेज
एग्जैक्टली कुछ ना कुछ तो वर्ड्स होता है, लाइक मैंने कुछ डाटा मेंशन किया था तो मैंने बोला कि 70% लोगों ने वोट किया जो वन ऑफ द हाईएस्ट है इंडियन डेमोक्रेसी में, है ना, अब तक के हिस्ट्री में का, तो काइंड ऑफ वेरी मच इसी बात पे मैं 4-5 लाइन 50 वर्ड्स में कवर कर सकता हूँ इसी टॉपिक,
लाइक अगर कोई वुमेन एम्पावरमेंट पे लिख रहा है तो वो क्या कर सकता है कि जो गवर्नमेंट के इनिशिएटिव्स हैं, बहुत सारी स्कीम्स हैं, वो हम पढ़ते ही हैं, ये सही तो वो रेफर कर सकते हैं, आपको बस सेंटेंस बिल्डिंग का आना चाहिए,
उसको लिंक करो, एक सेंटेंस का पिछले से लिंकअप होना चाहिए,
ठीक, ओके, दैट्स फॉर द इंग्लिश पार्ट, एंड यूर सजेशन फॉर द ईएसआई एफएम इंग्लिश, एनी स्पेशल इंस्ट्रक्शन टू द एस्पिरेंट्स, any mistake you made and that they should not made?
Yeah, actually मैं एग्जाम के ना लास्ट मोमेंट में करंट अफेयर को मैं रिवाइज नहीं किया, उसकी वजह से मैं ESI में मेरे उतने अच्छे मार्क्स तो नहीं आ रहे, आई एम श्योर 65 के अराउंड होगा, बट 70-75 लाया जा सकता था, तो प्लीज़ करंट अफेयर इज़ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट, रिवाइज दैट करंट अफेयर मीन फ्रॉम लिमिटेड सोर्सेज एंड रीड दोज अगेन एंड अगेन, एंड इट्स नॉट नेसेसरी कि आप किसी मटेरियल को सब्सक्राइब करो, या जरूरी नहीं है कि कोई महंगी महंगे कोर्स खरीद के करो, जो मतलब जो भी रिसोर्सेज हैं वो सब इंटरनेट पे अवेलेबल है, फ्रीली अवेलेबल है, बट वही है कि लिमिटेड रिसोर्सेज ही पढ़ो एंड उसको बस बार बार रिविजन करो।
ओके, सो नाउ कम्स टू द इंटरव्यू पार्ट,
एज यू सेड आई वाज मोस्ट वरीड अबाउट दिस फेज ऑफ द एग्जामिनेशन, like I was not from financial or economic background, have no relevant work experience.
ये भी एक question रहता है, बहुत सारे aspirants कहते हैं कि हम non financial background से हैं, तो हमारा interview में क्या रहेगा, मतलब हमारे इससे interview marks पे कोई impact पड़ेगा? तो
अभी तो I've not got my marks yet, but like I said कि I had no financial or economic background and no relevant work experience. तो आई वॉज वॉरिड वेरी मच, बट मैंने हरीश खेर जी का मॉक इंटरव्यू अटेम्प्ट किया था ऑफ क्रैक रेट, बिकॉज डेट वॉज हेल्पफुल, जो उन्होंने फीडबैक दिया दैट वॉज रियली हेल्पफुल, सो वट आई डिड वॉज कि मैं चाहता था कि मेरा इंटरव्यू लाइक फेज टू मैंने बहुत अच्छा किया था, आई एम गेटिंग अराउंड 150 मार्क्स मोर देन दैट इन फेज टू ESI एंड FM, और इंग्लिश भी मैंने एज आई सेड आई हैव डन क्वाइट वेल, सो इसमें भी 70 का मिल जाना चाहिए, सो मुझे पता था कि इफ़ आई गेट नॉर्मल मीन एवरेज मार्क्स इन इंटरव्यू आई विल इजीली गेट थ्रू, सो मैंने जो बायोडाटा है उसमें मैंने कुछ भी अपना बहुत बड़ा अचीवमेंट्स नहीं मेंशन किया, तो सिंपल जो भी अचीवमेंट है जो किया मैंने, वर्क एक्सपीरियंस जो रेलिवेंट वर्क एक्सपीरियंस है हमारे जो मेरा है उसको मेंशन किया, वो भी 2-3 लाइन में, ज़्यादा नहीं, सो दैट मीन्स वो कम क्वेश्चन पूछे, तो लाइक मेरा इंटरव्यू बस जस्ट 9 मिनट चला, सो आई वॉज वेरी मतलब 9 मिनट चला तो मैं डिसअपॉइंटेड तो था, लेकिन मैं भी चाहता था कि मैं ज़्यादा दिन हुआ इंटरव्यू हॉल में टाइम स्पेंड ना करूं, क्योंकि मैं ज़्यादा अगर टाइम स्पेंड किया और ज़्यादा उन्होंने पूछना स्टार्ट किया तो ये मेरे लिए मतलब पॉजिटिव नहीं रहेगा, तो आई थिंक मेरे को एवरेज मार्क किया होगा तो मैं इसलिए आई कुड इजीली मेक इट।
सो एनी सजेशन टू द एस्पिरेंट्स फॉर द इंटरव्यू, व्हाट शुड दे डू?
देखो इंटरव्यू में ना आई थिंक वन शुड रियली नॉट ट्राई टू सो कि वो जो नहीं है, ओवर स्मार्टनेस नहीं दिखानी चाहिए, एंड बी कॉन्फिडेंट मतलब इंटरव्यू हॉल में कॉन्फिडेंस तो हवा हो जाती है सबके साथ, ऐसा होता मेरे साथ भी हुआ था, बी नेचुरल, क्योंकि वो इंटरव्यू ले रहे हैं ना तो दे आर वेल अवेयर कि आप अगर इफ़ यू आर ट्राइंग टू प्रिटेंड ना तो दे विल इजली कैच यू, जस्ट बी नॉर्मल एंड डोंट सो योर ओवर स्मार्टनेस, मतलब लाइक मैं बोलना चाहूँगा देर आर टू काइंड्स ऑफ कैंडिडेट्स विथ लाइक जो इजीली इम्प्रेस कर सकते हैं पैनल को और लाइक दूसरे मेरे जैसे जो नहीं कर सकते. तो जो नहीं कर सकते हैं तो आपको मतलब प्रिटेंड नहीं करना, बी नेचुरल है ना, आप अपने स्ट्रेंथ पे खेलो रिलेटेड टू इट.
इकोनॉमी एंड बैंकिंग और फाइनेंशियल रिलेटेड कोई क्वेश्चंस बेसिक नॉलेज तो पूछी गई हो आपसे?
मेरे से रिलेटेड टू डिजिटल इकोनॉमी पूछा था और मेरे स्टार्टअप के बारे में पूछा था एंड दो चार क्वेश्चन तो इसी से थे जो जहाँ
मीन्स मतलब स्टूडेंट्स जो प्रिपेयर कर रहे हैं उनको सजेशन ये रहेगा कि बेसिक्स ऑफ इकोनॉमी एटलीस्ट आपको पता होना चाहिए. हाँ, तो, आरबीआई के फंक्शन के बारे में एटलीस्ट आपको.
हाँ मेरे से एक क्वेश्चन पूछा था कि व्हाई डू वी नीड सेंट्रल बैंक, ये तो रटा क्वेश्चन है, सिंपल सर, दैट एनीबॉडी कैन आंसर. फाइनेंशियल रेगुलेशन एंड क्या नाम है वो तो मतलब एक चाहिए ही ना सेंट्रल मतलब.
सो दैट्स इट फॉर द फेज टू इंटरव्यू. सो aspirants, this is just one inspirational story of Mr. Gup. So he is basically going from Delhi street to the Main street. Everyone has a dream, mostly bankers has a dream to go there. So you, it can help you and you can get the points from this strategy and you can prepare accordingly.